Welcome to this new mod map, first look map tour with me, MrSealyp. Smokey Mountain Logging. This is an interesting one, and quite a different proposition from any of the other maps that have come up on consoles at all. It is a strange one, but has piqued my curiosity. I have enjoyed on most of the maps and the let's plays I've done doing wood chipping. I have done logging on various different maps, although I do wood chipping predominantly over logging. So this, the whole forestry logging idea, is an intriguing one. So very quickly, this map is by FDR Logging, and I hope I get this right, MrRithisCatalyst. And it's good. It's not going to appeal to everybody, that's for certain. Very quickly, let's have a look at the main map. We have got a main tarmac area, platform area, whatever you want to call it. We've got the Stanton sawmill, we've got a barn, and we've got Wright Agribusiness. We've also got the store, we've got a gas station, all here on this deck, this platform. If we come out slightly, we have got a main kind of logging road into the logging area. There is the Gunson Trail, there is Tower 1, Fireweed Lake, we've got logging points 1, 2, 3 and 4. We've got Devil's Canyon, Tower 2, we've got the Willis Trail, we've got Slinger Ridge, and logging point number 4. And that's it. So straight away you think, well, that's actually quite small, isn't it? There's not really a lot to it. Don't be fooled. It is a lot bigger than it first appears. When we come across to prices, that's where it's a bit interesting. You can buy and sell all the crops available, but there are no fields at the moment. If I scroll across, and this is the only bit I'm a little bit not uncertain about, but kind of unhappy, I suppose, I don't know, is the wrong word. Wood chipping only pays $307 at the moment. Obviously that will go up and down, it will fluctuate, it will do whatever. That's not very high. That's a kind of giant software standard amount. But I would have thought for a forestry map maybe they would have given you more. I suppose the thing about it is there is so much forestry available, so many trees to cut down, so much logging to do, you're going to make money. You've got to do a lot of it to make money, but you're going to be able to do some. As far as how much they pay for lumber, I'm not quite sure at the moment. Like I say, this is a first look. This is something just having a look through, seeing what's available. If I come out and then go into vehicles, what do we start with? We start with two Valtras N series. We start with the Sampo Rose new Comia C6 Harvester, which again is interesting, with its header, a small trailer, a plough, a seeder, a pickup. The Stepper FHL 13AK, which is kind of a log grab lift trailer, that kind of thing. The Sampo Rosenew HR 46X, which is the small logging vehicle, tree cutter. I've struggled to use that often on maps because there aren't that many small trees. This will only do small girth trees. Obviously the Scorpion King will do anything, pretty much. But there will be a use for this at the start. You start with a chainsaw, which is obviously going to be quite handy when you begin. And that's what you begin with. This is a big open platform. Let's say the store is here, for machinery and equipment, gas station, Wright Agribusiness, we've got silo for storage, we've got a barn, and we've got the Stanton sawmill. I'm going to jump into the pickup, because that's going to be quicker to get around, if I can remember where it was parked. Yes, over the back here by the gas station. So, Let's back up out of here. Now, the interesting thing, around this very, very first sort of start point, around the tarmac area, there is already a lot of trees that you can start with cutting down. What I like, or what I've noticed straight away, is there is a mix. Thin trees, thick trees, very tall trees, you've got live trees, dead trees, you've got fallen trees. Let's be honest, it's a forestry map. There are going to be trees, and quite a lot of them. What's fascinating is the locations of them. Some of them are going to be tricky to get to. It's going to make the proposition of logging interesting. But there is no shortage of trees to cut down. I suppose the kind of challenge on this would be, can you deforest the entire map? Could you start from one side, work your way across, and just clear the map? It would take quite a while, I would imagine. But there's plenty to start off with if you want to start building your equipment, getting some money on the go. So, just quick whiz past the equipment. We've just had a look at it already, but here it is. So, your harvester, your first Veltra, seeder, plough, trailer. Then we come across here, we've got the other Veltra, and we've got the stepper, small kind of log trailer. The sell point for lumber is here, but not here, it's actually in here. So there's going to be no dumping it on the ground. You've got to get it in here. Again, interesting proposition. I've got a few ideas of how I might achieve that. But yeah, that's the sell point for your lumber. And around the back here, we have got our sell point for wood chips. There would be a combination of both, I think. I am considering having a go at this, actually, as a kind of mini Let's Play map. Again, I'm always worried I don't get caught out. You often find when a new map comes out, within the first week or so, you'll get an update because people find problems and issues. So, again, do I hang on, wait a week, see what happens? There have been a couple of new updates out actually today for Hagenstead and the Old Stream Farm version 2, and some great new mods as well. But I digress, let's move on with this one. If we head northwest out to the corner, we get our first logging trail. And when you look at the main map, get back to that. On the main map, we've got a lot of green area, which initially my kind of first thoughts were, okay, well, that's where your forests are, that's where your logging's going to be. It doesn't seem that big. When you look at the area of this here, in comparison to the areas you can log, you know, it's going to be interesting, but it's not going to be, you know, on a grand scale. How wrong I was. You can go off pretty much in any direction. Off the track, off the green areas, and there is forestry. There are canyons, there are ridges, there are rocky outcrops. The other thing I said, there are different types of trees, which, you know, you've got a lot of the pine ones, and then there, I know there are different sorts of pine trees, fir trees, but there are some cracking ones. If we come out here, and just on this main logging trail, the first stop is going to be here, at Gunson Trail. So, zoom right in. The Gunson Trail heads off to the right and kind of heads northeast up towards Tower 1, goes up around the top, all the way out here. You've got this small lake at the top here that runs down into Fireweed Lake, which is actually a lot bigger than it seems on the map. So, we'll have a quick wander up there. So, the Gunson Trail. If any of you have watched any of my Let's Plays before, any of my first lit videos, I do like an undulating map. I do like interesting topography, and this has got interesting topography. It is great. Like I say, there's not any real farming. There are no animals on this map at all. But that's probably an interesting change. You know, you're trying to work out, if you do Let's Plays and you do videos a lot, it's in your mind thinking, how do I make it different? How do I make it a bit edgy? How do I do something I haven't done in every single Let's Play? Well, this is it. This isn't the same as everything you've done before. And it does pose some problems. When you look at the kind of hillsides and the outcrops and the ridges and canyons, getting equipment up here is going to prove tricky and challenging. These are the types of trees I don't think I've come across before. The kind of standard fir trees you get quite a lot, but these ones are a little bit different. The girth of the trunks is a bit smaller than your kind of average standard giants kind of trees. So again, something a little bit different. The trail goes on for a little while. And we come to Tower 1. With commanding views of the surrounding area. Now, something I haven't come across yet, and I am intrigued again. This is a very intriguing map. I'm going to use the word intrigued a lot. Interesting views out across. You can go to the sides here and look out back towards the kind of main start area. Not even a township, is it really? I haven't come across any nuggets. Not a single gold nugget. Now, I don't know if there are none on the map. Or, like American Outback, is there one or a cluster of them, like there were on Lore Folds? I'm wondering if there is gold in them there hills. Whether somewhere on this map, in a craggy little canyon or an outcrop, or somewhere, there are nuggets to be found. I don't know. I could be completely wrong. There may be none at all. Now, where did the trail go from here? There we go. Right, so the trail continues on round and goes all the way around towards Slinger Ridge, which is over there. Or possibly over there, actually, I'm trying to think. Get my bearings. I'm going to go back to the pickup and we will continue the tour round. So, back to the pickup. And the point I was making before about the sort of green areas and the fact we've just gone off there up to Gunson Trail, up to Tower 1. If you look to the left here, this entire area, if I go kind of wandering off up here, this goes all the way back, all the way around. All of this can be logged, all of it, all the way up and round. And yeah, you can go way off the track. And there is logging to be done. So, moving swiftly on. Heading down the main logging trail again, or down or up it. Again, heading northwest. We come past Fireweed Lake. And like I say, this isn't small, it's not a tiny lake. On the map it looks quite small, but actually when you get to it, it's actually a fair size. Wonder if there's any good fishing here. Fireweed. I don't know what fireweed is, obviously being English. Is it an American thing? Fireweed, I get the impression it's something that would burn, I don't know. Burn your skin, possibly, or burn, well, I don't know. If you know what fireweed is, let me know. That there, over there, is Slinger Ridge, I think, with the big outcrop just there. So, back into the pickup. If I can find it. Now, if we take the first fork to the left off the logging trail, or on the logging trail, we head out towards Devil's Canyon. Really, really, I mean, look at that. That is just absolutely amazing. The map designers on this have done such a brilliant job. They really have. Interesting to look at. Great to drive around on. Logging is going to be, like I say, very, very interesting on this. Something a bit different. You get your customary, on any map, here's your logging area. This is a logging area. It's absolutely brilliant. So, Devil's Canyon. The trees are a lot more dense here, thicker trunks by the look of them, and it goes back a fair way. You're certainly not going to run out of lumber or timber quickly doing this map. It's going to take a while to clear this. Lost my pickup again. Where are we? There we go. Fantastic features. So, heading back out of Devil's Canyon. On the left-hand side, as we kind of look up, which is harder to do, but up there, which I need to get out, is Tower 2. Just up through there, which we'll come to later on. Now, the numbers on here, if you look on the map, we've got 1, 2, 3 and 4. I haven't been able to kind of quick jump to those. I assume those are just for reference points. If you were playing multiplayer or something like that, you can obviously refer to, you know, logging area 1, 2, 3 or 4. They've got a slightly larger kind of area that you can park on, put equipment, whatever it might be. Unless that's just a fault with console or my PS4 or whatever, maybe you are supposed to be able to jump to them, I don't know. So as we come back to the fork, and go back the way we were originally heading, we come to logging point 2, logging area 2, whatever you want to call it, right next to Fireweed Lake, and the other end of the Gunson Trail. So we carry on right the way around from Tower 1, comes all the way around, crosses over the little tributary that comes down to Fireweed Lake, and ends up here, passing underneath Slinger Ridge on its way. Coming back onto the logging trail, the main logging trail, as main as it gets really. Love that, driving under the tree that's fallen down. We take another fork in a moment, which will take us out towards logging point 3. Which is just here. And the start of the Willis Trail. The Willis Trail is this one here that runs up around the back, up to Tower 2, and overlooks the Devil's Canyon where we just were. We drove through under that natural archway, rock arch. So it takes us up around the top. And if you follow it all the way around, it takes you all the way up to Tower 2. Again, kind of right off, back out onto the green area. There are great views off the top of there. And I'm not going to go all the way along. I've done the Gunson Trail, part of that. The Willis Trail is up here and goes around the top. But let's be honest, you need something to explore yourself. If I do it all for you, what's the point of getting the map? You need somewhere to have a look. See if you can find that gold, if it exists. But that is logging point 3, the Willis Trail, which will lead over to Tower 2, which is, where are we going? Over there, somewhere. Right. And on to our last logging point on the map. And like I say, this is no small forest, this is no small logging area. This isn't what we're used to on a lot of the maps. Under another tree and out towards logging point 4. I cannot imagine what this map would look like once big chunks and big areas of this have been cleared. Now the interesting point being that having farming equipment available to you and a sell point for farming equipment, you can imagine clearing a lot of these areas, these grassy areas, and giving yourself some kind of meadows. It's almost like homesteading, I suppose. You're clearing the land and then you can plough some fields in. There's absolutely no reason why you can't, once you've cleared a big open area, plough a field. Stick some crops in as well. So have a mix of the two. If you want to just play it full on logging, that's entirely up to you. But there is the option. Some of these areas are going to be way too craggy, way too bumpy. You're not going to be able to plough or get a vehicle in or out. But some of them probably can. So, round 2, logging area 4. This is the furthest logging point away. We are now right up in the northwest corner. I say corner, not that it's got corners. The northwest edge of the map. We started right the way down here, and we've gone right the way across, all up to the top. Now, this whole area here, we haven't looked at all. So, what I'm going to do on foot, what I could do is a quad bike, really, or a motorbike, or something like that. Or a Land Rover. Come on, Giants, do a deal with Land Rover. I know they're not reliable. I've owned enough of them, but they're still cool. Right, we can go right the way out here. And this is the great thing I'm liking and enjoying about this map. Getting machinery in and out of here is not going to be easy. But you can go a long way out here. If you look at the small map down the left-hand bottom corner. I'm going round behind Slinger Ridge now. Right the way out. This map does not end at the green bits. There is a lot to see, a lot to find, a lot of logging to do that goes all the way around the back. And like I say, with some fantastic views, textures, it's a really good map. It's been really, really well done. And I'm really impressed with this. Like I say, to the point where I'm seriously considering doing a kind of short or mini let's play on this, just to see how well I can do in a shortish amount of time. But there we go. That's pretty much it. There's not really much else to say or show or do. It's a forestry map, and if you decide that you want to plough some fields into this somewhere and get some crops going as well to supplement it all, you probably can. Let's just go to this little outcrop here, overlooking the smaller lake, which is just here. And when you do the Gunson Trail, when you come around from Tower 1, which is over there, there's a small rickety, like the bridge there was in Sosnovka and a few of the maps like that, a small little rickety bridge across the river there, so you can get around. No shortage of trees, no shortage of lumber. This will be an interesting map to play on. Challenging, but fun, I would think. And if you did it as a multiplayer, yeah, I can imagine whole kind of logging teams in and out of here with lorries in and out and machinery going, and yeah, fascinating. It's such an interesting change from the maps you normally have, and that's what I think is really good about it. I think with the FS17 Platinum Edition coming out in November, this is an interesting change up from what the maps we've had before, leading into another change of interesting maps and that kind of thing with new crops. This is enough to keep it fresh. If you're not interested in logging, and this is just not going to be a map for you, you're not going to want to play on it. That's, you know, that goes without saying. It's a logging map. But I know a lot of people out there do like their forestry, do like logging. This will be the map for you. Have a go. I hope you found it interesting, informative, quick look around, see what's available, the machinery, the sell points, and a quick quiz round the map. And it is, as always when I do these, my first looks, it is a quick quiz round. It is by no means a comprehensive look at the map. There is loads more to see. Like I say, are there nuggets? I don't know. If you find any, if you know they're on there, let me know. But if you have enjoyed it, if you have found it useful or informative in any way, shape or form, hit that like button. If you don't subscribe yet, please do. If you want to leave a comment, feel free. And if you want to share this video, please be my guest. Whatever you should choose to do, from a small rocky outcrop on Smoky Mountain logging map, thanks for watching.